Hi, and welcome to my video about what is stage in the context of the Safe for DevOps Health Radar. Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. The Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox. Take out of this toolbox what fits your needs and what solves your problems. In the Safe for DevOps Health Radar, we start with the customer. The customer or the business, they have bright ideas, and these ideas are transferred into epics with a clear hypothesis statement. After that, we go into collaborate and research, where we are going to research the customer needs, and we also do the market research. Then we are going into architect, where we are going to architect the minimal architecture for proving this hypothesis. And after that, we are going into synthesize, where we are going to break down the epic into features, which we then bring onto a roadmap and into our backlog. In the develop step, we are going to break down the features into user stories, which we are then going to implement. After that, we commit our code. Our code gets reintegrated with the rest of the code. We're going to build the code. We are going to do the static code analysis, and we execute the unit test so that we have a deployable artifact. The deployable artifact is then deployed onto a test environment where we are doing the integration tests and also the end-to-end tests. After that, we are going to deploy into a staging environment. Let us now have a look what we are doing there. In the stage environment, we are doing the final validation to find out if we are production ready or not. So there we are going to do the user acceptance testing. Why are we doing this? We need to be sure that we are production ready. And this is also a very good chance for the business to have a look at what we have in the stage environment and to do the final user acceptance tests there. To do this, we need to have a stage environment. The definition of a stage environment is that it matches the production environment. So it is a one-to-one copy of the production environment. We already have discussed that in the test end-to-end. You may recognize that. There we had test environments, and there we also said the test environment should be as near as possible to the production environment as we can. But here in stage, we now really need to have this matching of the production environment. With that, we are really able to test end-to-end our software in a production-like environment so that we are able to do the user acceptance testing there. When we have done the build and the test end-to-end in the lower stages, we are going into the staging environment, and in the best case, we fully automatically deploy into the stage environment and execute the automatic end-to-end tests there. To enable our stakeholders to test always in a staging environment, we can use the blue-green deployment. To do that, we have two production-like environments. One production-like environment is live, and the other one is idle. In front of these two environments, we have a load balancer, which can switch between these environments. When we now have a new version of our software and we want to do the verification before going into production, we deploy this new version into the idle environment. When this is done, we switch the load balancer to the new environment with the new version of the software, and then all the users will use the new version of the software on the new live environment. The other environment is then idle and can be used for another deployment. The big benefit of doing that is if there is a problem, then we can figure that out without affecting the people who are using the live environment, for example, for testing, and we can figure the problem quickly out on this idle environment. Or even if there is a problem when we have switched the new version on, then we can easily also switch back to the old version. We need the stage environment to do the system demo, because only with the stage environment we can every 2 weeks integrate with the rest of the software and show to our stakeholders what we have achieved in this 2-week sprint, and the stakeholders are able to give us feedback and they can also say yes, this is good for production, or no, this needs some rework. The output of the stage step is that we have a deployable artifact which is now ready for production. We also have got all of the test evidence, so this is important when we have regulations in place, and we also have gathered feedback from our stakeholders in the system demo, but also on the stage environment with the user acceptance test. And as always, the Safe for DevOps Health Radar is also an assessment. You can download the assessment here. It is an Excel file where you can assess yourself. Staging involves deploying features to a full copy of the production environment from where they can be demonstrated to stakeholders, user acceptance test, and hosted for training purpose prior to production launch. Rate your team's ability to stage features in full production-like non-test environments for final validation prior to production deployment. You are sit when no staging environment exists or we use a test environment for staging. You are crawl when features are deployed manually to staging environment once every PI or every 3 months. You are walk when features are deployed to staging environment once per month and demonstrated to product management. And you are run when features and infrastructures are auto-deployed to a staging environment every iteration or sprint and accepted by product management. And you are a fly when stories, changes and infrastructure are auto-deployed to a staging environment, validated and immediately proceed to deployment. The stage step is a crucial step to get the final approval from our stakeholders. In the stage environment, we are doing our system demos and we also do the user acceptance testing there, and with that we also have an environment for doing the education of people and a demo environment to show the system to our stakeholders so that they can give us the final approval to go into production. Of course, in the best case, everything is automated, so we automatically deploy into the stage environment and we have their automated tests which are executed, and our package is then automatically deployed into production. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel because I create a video every week for you.